हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ई लर्निंग क्लासेस ऑफ पी एन एम एस सी हाई स्कूल। एज यू ऑल नो, वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ साइंस, दैट इज फूड, वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम। एंड आई होप यू ऑल हैव अंडरस्टूड टिल फूड मटेरियल्स एंड सोर्सेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द सेम। सो I request each and every one of you to open your textbooks and come on page number 3. What do we conclude from activity 3? Plants are the sources of food, ingredients like grains, cereals, vegetables and fruits. Animals provide us with milk, meat products and eggs. Cows, goats and buffaloes are some common animals which gives us milk and milk products like butter, cream, cheese and curd are used all over the world. Can you name some other animals which gives us milk? Okay, so in this particular paragraph it has been asked that what we have concluded, that is what we understood from the activity 3. Your activity 3 was about the food items, their ingredients and the sources from where those ingredients comes from. So let me again give you a summary of the same. With the help of this chart you can understand this paragraph very easily. That is, sources of ingredients, that is where the ingredients come from, which is the particular ingredient and what food items or dishes are made from the same. Very first you can see the picture of cow, buffalo and goat. We get milk from these animals. So source of ingredients is cow, buffalo, goat, that is animal. We get ingredient, that is milk, and the food item or food dishes which is prepared from this ingredients is butter, cheese, curd and so on. Next source is hen. Hen gives us eggs, and the people who prefer to eat non-veg or people who prefer to eat eggs makes dishes like omelette, egg bhurji and so on. The last source you can see is wheat plant. That is, from wheat we prepare flour, that is atta or maida, and then from this ingredient the food item like roti, bread, biscuits, noodles etc. is prepared. So this was the short summary of your activity 3. Now come back to your page number 3. So let's start with 1.3, that is plant parts and animal products as food, that is parts of plants and the animal product that are consumed as food. Plants are one source of our food. Which part of a plant? We eat many leafy vegetables. We eat fruits of some plants, sometimes roots, sometimes stem and even flowers. That means in our day-to-day life, we eat many vegetables, that is leafy vegetables, and we also consume the fruits of some plants. Sometimes we consume roots, sometimes we consume stems, sometimes we consume flowers, and so on. In the bracket, figure 1.4, have you ever eaten pumpkin flowers dipped in rice paste and fried? Try it. Figure 1.4 needs to ask you that, have you ever eaten pumpkin flowers? Pumpkin is a fruit and it also has the flowers. So they need to ask you, have you ever eaten the flowers which has been dipped in the rice paste and then fried? If not, then do try it. Now first let's understand about the parts of the plants and then we will continue with the same. So you can see the figure in which different edible parts of plants आर शोन टू अस. द वेरी फर्स्ट यू कैन सी द फ्लावर, नेक्स्ट यू कैन सी द फ्रूट, नेक्स्ट यू कैन सी द स्टेम ऑफ द प्लांट, नेक्स्ट इज द लीव्स. नेक्स्ट व्हेन यू कम डाउनवर्ड्स यू विल सी द बड. On the left hand side you can see the node and internode. All these are known as shoot system of the plant. When you come downwards you can find primary root and secondary root. These are known as the root system of the plant. Now the edible parts like flowers, fruits, leaves and so on. We are going to study about the same in the next paragraph. Some plants have two or more edible parts. Edible means eatable, which you can eat, which you can consume. This means that there are some plants which have two or more than two parts which can be consumed. Seeds of mustard plants gives us oil and the leaves are used as a vegetable. That is the mustard plant that gives us oil as well as the leaves of the same are used as vegetables. Can you think of the different parts of a banana plant that are used as food? So now it has been asked to you that can you think about the different parts of banana plant that are used by us as a food? Think of more examples where two or more parts of a single plant are used as a food. Now you have to think and give some examples where two or more parts of the single plant are used as a food. Now look below at the table 1.4, plant parts as a food. The example one is given to you, food item with plant as the major source. The next column is of ingredients or sources. And the third one is plant part which gives us the ingredient. The first one is brinjal curry. If we have to prepare the brinjal curry, which ingredients or what ingredients are needed? Firstly, we need brinjal. Next, we need chili as spice. And the other item we need is oil from groundnut, mustard, soya bean or any other plant. That is, three things are commonly used. If we need to prepare brinjal curry, we need brinjal. We need red chili powder or chili, green chili as spices. And we need oil, which can be groundnut, mustard, soya bean or from any other plant. From where does these ingredients come from? Brinjal fruit. Chili as spice is also a fruit. And the next we get oil from seeds. So the two columns are empty for you. Here you are going to write an example of the same. The food item, the source and from which part of the plant we get that ingredient. Now turn your page and come on page number 4. On the page number 4, you can find the box where it is written that do not try to taste unknown plants around you to see if they are edible. Some plants can be poisonous. This means you should not try eating or tasting every plant around you which you see, because some plants are edible but some can be poisonous at the same time. Now let's start with the activity 4, and it is about from all the food items you have listed in table 1.3, choose those items whose ingredients are obtained from plants. Which part of plant? Identify these and list the food items and plant parts as shown in the table 1.4. As I already told you, to fill the columns empty in the table 1.4, where you are going to write the name of the food items with plant as a major source, then you are going to write the ingredient and then the name of the part of the plant which gives us that ingredient. Now, activity 5, Take some dry seeds of moong or chana. Put a small quantity of seeds in the container filled with water and leave this aside for a day. This means you have to take a handful of moong, or you can take the chana as well. Then you have to put that in a container which is filled with water, and then you have to keep it aside for a day. Next day, drain the water completely and leave the seeds in the vessel. Now, the next day when you wake up, you have to empty the water. You have to drain out the water, and then you have to leave the moong or the chana in the vessel. Wrap them with a piece of wet cloth and set aside. Then you have to wrap them off with a piece of a cloth, wet cloth, and then you have to keep it aside. The following day, do you observe any changes in the seed? And then you need to check the next day, that is the third day, do you see the change in the moong or the chana? A small white structure may have grown out of the seeds. If so, the seeds have sprouted. Now, the third day when you will remove that wet cloth, you will find the white structure have grown. That is, you will find that moong has been grown or chana has been grown, which is known as sprouted. The seeds have been sprouted. You can see in the figure 1.5 and 1.6. The very first figure or the very first picture is of moong, and then you can see those white structure, that is sprouted moong. Same as with chana, you can see the chana in the first picture, and then you can see those white structure, that is sprouts. If not, wash the seeds in water, drain the water and leave them aside for another day. And if you see that after removing that wet cloth, you don't see or you don't find that white structure, again you have to wash those seeds in the water or keep them in the water. Then again you have to drain out the water and then keep those moong or chana again for a day, covered with a wet cloth. The next day, see if the seeds have sprouted, and the next day you have to check that seeds have been sprouted or not. After washing these sprouted seeds, you can eat them. And when you find that white structure on the seeds, then you have to wash them off, and then you can eat the same, you can consume the same. They can also be boiled, add some spices and get a tasty snack to eat. These sprouts can also be boiled in the water, and then you can add the lemon juice, the black pepper powder, red chili powder, some salt. You can also add the cucumber, tomato, and then you can mix and have it as a breakfast, or you can also have it as an evening snack. You can eat this healthy food. Do you know where honey comes from or how it is produced? Now, it's all about the honey. Do you know from where we get the honey or how it is being produced? Have you seen a beehive where so many bees keep buzzing about? Have you ever seen the beehive where bees live and they keep buzzing around? Bees collect nectar, that is sweet juices from flowers, convert it into honey and store it in their hives. Now, what does bees do? Bees sit on a flower and collect the nectar, that is sweet juice of the flower, and then convert it into honey. And then they store that honey in their hives. You can look figure 1.7, you can find the beehive over there. Flowers and their nectar may be available only for a part of the year. So bees store this nectar for their use all through the year. As you can see, or you know something about the flowers and the nectar may be available only for a part of the year. We can't find the flower, particular flower, or the nectar from that flower throughout the year. It is for a part of the earth. So bees store the nectar, they collect the juice and store the nectar for their use that they can use throughout the year. When we find such a beehive, we collect the food stored by the bees as honey. When we see or when we find beehive somewhere, we collect the food stored by bees. We collect all that nectar and then we use it as a honey. So, now let's understand the process of collecting honey from the following pictures. The very first picture you can see of a flower and a bee collecting sweet juice, that is nectar, from it. Bees collect nectar, that is sweet juice, from the flowers. Next one is, then they convert the nectar into the honey and store in their hives. The bees, they collect all this nectar and then they convert the nectar into the honey and they store it into the hives. The next is, we extract the honey from their hives. We go and we just extract the honey from their hives, but we can't go like this. We have to wear some special clothes or else the honey bees will bite us. And the last process is, this is how we get honey in the market. And while extracting the honey from the hives, it is processed and we get the honey in the market. Now, let me show you a small video how bees collect the nectar. I hope by looking at the video, you all have understood how honey, that is how nectar, is being collected by the bee and then they process it into the honey and we get it the same in the market. Now, let's continue with the explanation. The next one is 1.5, that is, what do animals eat? Now we are going to study about what animals consume, what do they eat to survive. Do you have cattle or a pet that you take care of, a dog, cat, buffalo or a goat? That means, do you have the pet animal at your house or the animal you take care of, which can be dog, cat, buffalo, cow or goat or any of the pet? You will then surely be aware of the food the animals eat. If you have pet animal at your house or if you are taking care of any of the pet animal or any of the street animal, then you must be knowing that what do they eat, what do they consume. What about other animals? Have you ever observed that a squirrel, that is you can see in figure 1.8, pigeon, lizard or a small insects may be eating as their food? You can get information or you know about what the dog, cow, buffalo, goat, cat eats. But do you know about the small animals, that what do they eat? For example, what do squirrel eat? What does pigeon eat, lizard or any other small insects? Now, we are going to study about the same in our coming video. Now, you all are going to read till here, that is still activity 1.8, and you will make sure that you have understood whatever is being taught to you in our today's video. So my dear students, this is all about today's explanation. We are going to continue with the same in our next coming video. Till then, keep reading, stay home, stay safe. Thank you, take care, bye.